Hi, my name is Ronald Johnson. And what I do is I help people that are tired of who they are and where they are in life. Are you in a situation that you lack self-esteem, low confidence, and you feel stuck and it's affecting all facets of your life and relationships? This is where I can help. So today's liveliest topic is going to be about, do you check in with yourself? And what I mean by do checking with yourself is if you're so busy with work, with kids, with life, with trying to get promoted with all these different things that can come at you all at once. How do you navigate that and how you take care of yourself? I think this is very important for us to realize 2020 has been a difficult year and self-care should be on top of everyone's list outside everything else. And self-care means self-care for you. So I'm gonna talk about a great example of did I check in with myself? So a couple of days ago, I applied for this position at a place called betterup.com, which people can, corporations can find life coaches, right? Coaches like myself and other people out there. So I went through the orientation, I did an assessment, I submitted my application. I was like, great, I'm going to possibly get this job. So I checked in last week as a follow-up. Hey, what's going on? Any updates? 2 days later, I get an email back saying that I did not get the position and there are plenty of candidates. It was very competitive, and you know how the normal email goes. And inside my heart just sank in my chest, like I did not get the position. What did I do wrong? Am I educated enough? Did I not say the right things? How I was assessed? Oh man, I hate assessments. All these things are coming up my mind. And this is where I had to check in with myself. Ron, did you really want that job? No, I did not. I was just doing it to try and see what happens, and I didn't get it. And as much effort as, or sorry, as minimum effort as I put into it, I didn't get much out of it. So why should I be upset or why should I be hard on myself? I didn't really want it anyways. I want to work on something else. Now, granted, if I got the position, it'd been great, but I had to first check in with myself because when I got the email, my energy level dropped down low. I was overcome with frustration. I was scared, anxiety, all these kind of, I would say, triggers would come up for everybody else. I mean, if you didn't get your job or something bad that you didn't like happened to you, you may not feel well. So I had to check in with myself. And that's what I did. And this is how I checked in with myself. I asked myself questions. Is this what you really want to do? Answer was no. Is this what you hope for? Answer was no. How much effort did you put into it? Answer was very minimum. So why should I be upset that I put minimum effort into something I didn't really want? And that's when you might check in with yourself. This is very crucial because we don't check in with yourself. Usually what happens, you realize one day you wake up and you lack energy. You are exhausted. You are tired. You are realizing, man, I'm just going and going. When I'm taking care of myself, when can I go on vacation? All these things can be happening. But how you're checking with yourself is what brings you happiness and where you find joy? That's how you check in with changing those energy levels or changing being exhausted. Is it I actually do what I enjoy doing? Is it making me really happy? And if you're saying, no, I did not do what's making me happy, I didn't check in with myself, then okay, what do I need to do? Or more importantly, what are your values? Values can be time with friends and family. Values can be taking a nap. Values can be self-care. Values could be whatever they are personally for you. Understand and write down your personal values and how they can actually help you. Because if you don't, you realize, wait a minute, I'm doing, but it's not in line with my values. Let me get back in line with my values. Because when you in line with your values, it provides you overall happiness. And that's the key, is happiness for yourself. So checking in with your values, understanding your values, will be the best keys to actually getting much better and feeling better. That's the key is. The key here is really just being better, feeling better, doing things you enjoy, self-care, checking in with yourself. Because when you're checking in with yourself, what it does, and when these frustrations or things come up that didn't feel well, checking in yourself allows you to heal yourself. I give example of the job. Did I really want it? I had to check in with myself. No, I did not. How much effort did I put in? Check in with myself. No, I did not. So it relinquished that fear, that doubt. Now, let me tell you the fear. The fear was, well, if I don't get the job or take on more clients, I won't have enough money. That was the fear. But I asked myself another question. How is that really true for me? And it's not really true. I'm still okay, even if I didn't get the job. So again, I checked in with myself. And that right then and there was, it took about 2 hours. I had the email about 9 a.m. on a Sunday. It took about 2 hours until I was able to actually change that and go into a different state of mind. So I went, that dipped down because I was like, oh, I can't believe this happened to me. Why am I going through this? Then 2 hours later, I got my energy back. And it was furthest from my mind because I promoted self-care and self-healing. So again, the way to check in with yourself is in line with your value systems. What makes you happy? What do you enjoy doing? The more you do the things you enjoy doing, the more you have room in your mind for creativity, the more you have room in your mind for things that make you feel happy and in line with what you want. So I hope this enjoyed this video. I hope it helped out how to check in with yourself. I can go probably a little bit deeper, but stay tuned to my YouTube channel under Ron Johnson Life Coach, where I dive in deeper ego, mindset, consciousness of how to actually get rid of that. But just a simple video on how to do that. But if you're still stuck, guess what? I offer virtual seminars. For those out there that, you know, with COVID and things being closed, you need an outlet, go to www.ronbusinesscoaching.com, click on virtual seminars, and right there you can sign up for a virtual seminar and know the steps how to promote self-care. As a matter of fact, I have one coming up this weekend, Saturday, November 21st, from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. PST. This is where how to embrace uncertainty during difficult times. I'm going to have a special guest named Ryan Stanley. He has a book called Be Joyful, Be Happy, Be Present. And you too can do the same thing. Be happy, be joyful, and be present at the same time. So stay tuned. Join the virtual seminar so you can feel better. Remember, I'm Ron Johnson. And what I do is I help people that are tired of who they are and where they are in life. And if you feel stuck, you're not happy, and it's affecting all facets of your life, from relationships to friends and success, this is where I can help, because I've been there. Thanks for listening.